In this video, I will give an overview of a Fuji PID industrial PID controller. So here's the contents of this video. First, short introduction of how you configure and set the different settings on this Fuji controller. Then I will test the device and see if it's working as expected. I will use a simple test program in order to test the device and connect it to your computer using a DAC device. Then I will use the PID, the Fuji controller, as a PID controller and run it in hardware in the loop simulation and testing mode using a software application on my computer, which is connected to a DAC device. And finally, I will see how you can use or show how you can use the built-in auto-tuning feature in this PID controller. So first, introduction. So basically, the Fuji PID controller is a PID controller used in industrial processes. So we have a process and we have a PID controller, and the output of the process is sent back to the controller, and then we have a reference value. And then the PID controller calculates the error between the reference value and the measured value. And based on that error, it calculates a proper control signal that are sent to the process. So this is a typical feedback system. And in this video, we will use this Fuji PXG5 PID controller as an example. So here you see an overview of this Fuji controller, where you can see the process value, and we can set the set value here in the front, and we have connections in the back. And in order to demonstrate this Fuji controller, we will use this air heater process in order to control the process using this Fuji PID controller. So basically, the process will be this air heater process, which is a small scale industrial process. And the PID controller here will be this Fuji PXG5 PID controller. So basically, this is the control system that will be demonstrated in this video. We have the process in form of an air heater process, and we have also created a mathematical model of that process, which we are controlling using this industrial PID controller. Here you see the back side of this Fuji PID controller. So then we have here we connect power supply, either 24 voltage or 230 voltage. Then we connect the process value or the measurement value here, and typically, it's a voltage signal that you connect here. And then, based on this process value and the set point we set on the Fuji controller, it calculates a proper control signal that we can send back to the process. In this video, I will set it to be a current signal. And then on the back side here, I'm using a 250 ohm resistor in order to convert it to a 0 to 5 voltage signal that goes back to the process. Or if you're running a mathematical model on your computer on to the DAC device and through your computer. Basically, when we has wired the correct wiring here on the back side, we mainly use the front panel in order to set the set value here and read the process value. So on top we have the PV or the process value, and in the bottom here we set the set value or SV, short for set value. So in green we have the set value, and in red we have the process value. So the process value are coming from the process, while we set the set value here, and based on the set value, the PID controller calculates a proper control signal or a manipulated value and send it back to the process. We adjust the set point by clicking the up and down button in order to adjust the set value. So let's take a short demo how you can to give a short overview of this Fuji PXG5 controller. Here you have the Fuji PXG5 PID industrial controller. So here you see the front panel where you see the process value. LLL means that there are no signal connected here, so then it just shows this LLLL. And you connect a signal here, let's say from the air heater process, it will show the value here, either in the voltage, or you can convert the signal to engineering unit for the air heater process. It will then show the temperature value here. So the conversion will happen inside the Fuji PID controller, and here in the bottom you can set the set point, and also here you can set if you want to show it in voltage, in percent, or in engineering unit. Typically you want to have it in engineering unit like this, 26 degrees Celsius. So you just click on the arrow up or arrow down in order to change the set value and the reference value. So this is the value you want the process to stay on. So then you can just set it to any value you want here. On the back side, you connect here the process value. Typically this will be a voltage signal between 0 and 5 voltage or 1 to 5 voltage. And then the conversion is happening inside the PID controller, and you will display the engineering unit here in the display. And then this one will calculate a proper control signal based on the process value and the set value. And then you can hook up the control value here, or the manipulated value, and send it to your process. And also for this specific Fuji controller, there's a resistor here. So from this one, there's a signal in milliampere that are converted to a voltage signal on output here.
Now I will go through how you can configure the Fuji PXG5 controller and set different settings in different channels. So the Fuji controller has different channels where you can adjust the different settings. Mainly we will use channel number 1, channel number 2, and channel number 6. So channel number 1, you can set if the controller should be in manual mode or in automatic mode. So when it's manual, it's set to off. There's a closed loop control, and the PID controller performs a PID behaves like a ordinary PID controller, and it retrieves process value and calculates a proper manipulated value and send it back to the process. If you set manual to true, you can act as the controller yourself. You can adjust the manipulated value between 0 and 100%. Also, there's possibility to set the set value either locally, which we will use, or remotely. So if you want to set it remotely, you set this to remote, but in most cases you set it to locally like this. And also it has a built-in auto-tuning feature that we will demonstrate later, but for now you just set AT to off. So that's channel number 1. For channel number 2, since you're going to control this air heater process, there are two different air heater processes. Some has a range between 0 and 50 degrees Celsius, which corresponds to 1 to 5 voltage. or some of the other air heaters has the range between 20 and 50 degrees Celsius. The air heater I'm using has the range between 20 and 50 degrees Celsius, so I need to go into channel number 2 and set the lower set value limit to be 20 and the upper set value limit to be 50. So that's channel number 2. In channel number 6, we can set the same for the process value. The lower limit, in my case, should be 20 degrees Celsius, and the upper process value limit should be 50. You can also specify number of decimals here in channel 6, so then you can set PVD equals to 0 or 1, depending on if you want a decimal point or not. Also, you need to specify the controller output, since, as mentioned earlier, I'm using a 250 ohm resistor on the back side of the Fuji controller in order to convert the ampere value to a voltage value. So then I want the output of the controller to be a value between 0 and 20 milliampere, and then this resistor is adjusting this value to be a value between 0 and 5 voltage. So that's the different channels you need to set. There are lots of more channels and lots of more settings. So make sure that you read the instruction and the user guide for this Fuji PID controller carefully before you use it. So then let's have a short demo where we go through these different settings. There are lots of settings you can set on this Fuji PID controller. You can set the settings in different channels. So in order to go into these channels, you just hold this button for a few seconds, this select button, hold it for a few seconds like this, and now you see channel 1, and then you use the arrow up and down, channel 2, channel 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, etc. So you have different channels, you can set different settings. Let's just, in order to go into this specific channel, you just click on select, and then you go into these different settings. So now I'm inside channel 1, and one setting here is manual mode. It can be set to either. So in order to change this value, now it's set to off. This means that the PID controller works as expected. So now the built-in PID controller is working. If you set it to on, you will turn this device into manual mode, and then you can set this the manipulated value by clicking the buttons here of up and down. So then, in order to change it to on, I just click on the select, and it starts blinking, and then I use the arrows, and then I can set it on and just click select once more. And now this setting has been saved into the device. So now I'm running the device in manual mode. This means you can control the process manually. So that's one setting. That's in channel number 1. I'll just switch it back to off, like this. Some other settings in channel number 1. This is seen here. Let's go to next channel, channel 2. So in channel 2 you can set the PID settings. So you have P, I and D. So in order to change them, you just
Click on select button and it starts blinking, and then you can use the arrow up and down in order to change the value. And then just click select once more in order to save it. Here's the eye, it's 20 seconds. Click on select in order to change it. Click once more in order to save it. Like this. And here's the D settings. So here we can set the lower set value limit. So since I'm using this air heater process, and the process value goes between 20 and 50 degrees Celsius, I set the lower set value limit to be 20. And here's the upper set value limit. I have set it to 50. So then I have lower limit 20 and the upper limit is 50. So that's channel number 2. Let's go to channel number 6. Here we have the lower limit for the process value, and also we set the same here, since the, in my case the process value goes from 20 to 50 degrees Celsius. If you use another air heater, it could go from 0 to 50, but in my air heater it goes from 20 to 50. So here I set the lower process value limit to be 20, and here is the upper process value. I set it to be 50. In order to change it, you just click on the select button. It starts blinking, and then you can change it up and down like this. And in order to store it, you just click select once more, like this. Let's go through some others. Here you set can set a number of decimals on the display when you present the process value. And the set value, you can set how many digits you want to present the values in. So I just set it to 0 decimal values. Here you set the range for the control output, and as mentioned, the output is here. But this resistor, as you see here, converts. So this should be in milliampere, and then this one is converting the value to a voltage signal. So the output here should be a voltage signal. So that's why I set the output to be between 0 and 20 milliampere. And then this will convert the value from 0 to 5 voltage on the output here. So that's the range of the control output of the PID controller. So these are some important settings that you need to set on this Fuji device.
So now we got familiar with this Fuji PXG5 PID controller, and we have set some settings. So now we are ready to test the device and make sure it works as expected. So in order to test the device, I have made a simple test software. I'm using a USB 6008 DAC device that are sending the process value to the Fuji controller as an analog output signal from this test software, and then it reads back the manipulated value that are retrieved from the Fuji PID controller. So in order to make this simple test software, you are able to see if you have set up the device properly. So here you see the program or the block diagram. This is a simple test program created with LabVIEW. So I'm just sending an analog output, which is the process value in this case, to the DAC device, and I wire the DAC device to the Fuji controller, and then I read back the manipulated value, the control signal, using an analog input, and then I present it here on my front panel. that's basically the test software. So let's just go through a simple demo where we use this test software.
So now I have connected the Fuji controller to a DAC device, an NI USB 6008 DAC device from National Instruments. So then I have an analog output here, which I have connected here as the process value. And then back, the control signal from the Fuji controller is going back to the DAC device as an analog input. Then you see in the Fuji controller, you see the process value here. Now it's 20 degrees. And then you see the set point here. And then I have made a small program that are testing the communication between this Fuji controller and the DAC device. So then first this process value are now coming a signal coming from the PC, which is between 1 and 5 voltage. And then it's converted to engineering unit here on this device from 20 to 50 degrees Celsius. So now the process value here is 1 voltage. This means it's converted to 20 degrees Celsius, which is the lower limit. So then I can change it to 5 voltage here in this application. And then you see it goes up to 50 degrees Celsius. So that's the upper limit. I can put it to 2 voltage. And then it goes down to the new process value, which is in this case 28 degrees Celsius. And the opposite way, here I can read the manipulated value that comes from this Fuji controller through the DAC device and to my software program here. So this is in voltage, 0 to 5 voltage, and then I convert it from 0 to 100%. So that's the manipulated value that either comes from the PID controller inside here, or you can set it in manual mode. So in order to set it in manual mode, I just click on this AM button for a few seconds. Just need to hold it in. And then you see it changed to this new symbol O, which means now I'm running this device in manual mode. So now I'm the controller. So I can set here on the front panel, I can change the controller value from 0 to 100%. So let's go just use the arrow down and set it to 0%. And then you see in my graphical user interface, it shows 0 voltage and 0 in percent. So then I change it to, change it to 20%. And this means 1 voltage, or also this conversion, 20%. So you see that's correct. I can make it up to 50%. So that's the control signal or manipulated value I'm controlling now. So I'm acting as a controller instead of using the built-in PID algorithm. So now it's set to 50%, the control signal. That indicates a voltage of 2.5 voltage. Or the conversion here, you see that the value is correct. You can change it to 100%. Like this, and then you see the output now that goes from this device to the DAC device is 5 voltage. And then you see it's correct, 100%. That's how you can test the Fuji controller by using a DAC device in order to interface it. So then you can change the process value here on the computer, and then you can change the manipulated value here on the Fuji controller, and then you can read the value here on your computer like this.
So now we are familiar with the device. We have done the necessary configuration and settings, and we have tested the device, so we make sure that it works as expected. Now we are ready to start using it. So let's perform our PID control, and we will also use something called hardware in the loop simulation and testing. So basically, we will use the Fuji PID controller as the controller in our control loop, and we will have this process, but instead of the real process, we will use a mathematical model. So we will implement the mathematical model in a software on our computer, and we will use a DAC device as an interface between the process and the industrial PID controller. The first thing we need to do is to set the PID parameters. We set the PID parameters in channel number 2. So we set P, I, and D. And you have to notice that for the Fuji PID controller, we set this P as a proportional band, which means this is in order to convert from ordinary KP, we have to use this formula. So assume we set or find KP using a tuning method like Skogestad or other tuning methods. We find KP to be 0.8. Then we need to use this formula in order to find the proportional band we need to set in the Fuji controller. So then, applying this formula, we find PB to be 125, so that's the value we need to set here, while I and D is in seconds. Also here I have created a test software. So I'm using this Fuji PID controller in order to control the process, but actually the process is running on my computer in form of a mathematical model, and also this is referred to as hardware in the loop simulation and testing. And then I can test this controller before I can apply it on the real system. So let's take a short demo of this test software.
So in this example, I'm now running the Fuji controller. I'm controlling a process in form of a mathematical model that is running on my computer. So I've connected the Fuji controller with my computer using this DAC device. Then I have made the program that you see here in the background. Here you see the process value that comes from the mathematical model that is running on inside this program. And then the output of this model is sent to the Fuji controller through the DAC device. And then the Fuji controller acts on this process value and perform a proper control signal according to the PID algorithm implemented in the Fuji controller. So now you see the process value is now at this moment 24 degrees Celsius, and the set value is 24 degrees Celsius. So now I'm running the process on the set value, and let's change it to, let's say, 25 degrees Celsius. And then you observe in the background here on my software, the controller starts to react a bit, and you also see the process value starting to increasing. Now it's 24.2 degrees Celsius, 24.3, and you see also the control signal how it's react on the change in the set value. Now it's 24.4, 5. So you see it's reaching the new set value, and now you see on the real Fuji control here the set point has been reached. So now the process value is 25 and the set value is 25. So you can use this test software called hardware in the loop in order to test the hardware device, in this case this Fuji controller, and you can see if this device are able to control the process that you're going to control. by changing the set value. You can go inside here in channel number 2, where you set the P, I, and D parameters, so you can change these values and see how the system reacts. So by changing P, you just click select here, it starts blinking, and then you change a value here between 0 and unlimited percent. So this is in proportional band. You have to note that the Fuji controller sets the P parameter in proportional band, so this is 125%. So that's P, and I is in seconds, so now I'm setting it to 20 seconds, and D is 0, so now I'm running a PI controller like this.
The Fuji PX G5 PID controller has also a built-in auto-tuning feature that we should use. So you set the auto tuning in channel number 1, and then you have go to this AT for auto tuning, and normally this is set to off, but when you set this value to on, the auto tuning is starting. Typically takes a few minutes, and then it finds proper PID parameters automatically. So let's show how we can perform an auto tuning using this Fuji PX G5 PID controller.
Let's see how we can use the built-in auto tuning feature in this Fuji PX G5 PID controller. So I have the same test software here in the background, where I'm using a mathematical model and a proper DAC device. In this case, a USB 6008 DAC device. So I control and this mathematical model that are implemented in software here by using this Fuji controller. So now you see the process value is 25, and the set value is 25. So now, as you see in the program in the background, it's running smoothly, and the process and the set point is the same. So now let's apply the auto-tuning feature, but first I just go inside and check the PID settings. So I click on holding down the select button for a few seconds, and then I can select between the different channels. So the PID settings is in channel number 2. So I hold the select button down, and then you see the settings I'm using now. P is 125, I is 20 seconds, and D is set to 0. So that's the PID settings that the controller is using at the moment. But now I will switch to auto tuning feature. Then I just hold in select, and then the auto tuning feature is in channel number 1. So then I go into channel number 1 and select AT auto tuning. It's now set to off. So when I set this, change this to hold on, click on the select button in order to change the value. So now I change the auto tuning to on, and this means that the Fuji controller will use the built-in auto tuning algorithm in order to find an optimal set of PID parameters. So when I set this to on now and select it, go back to the main panel, you see this blinking. This means that the auto-tuning is set to on. And now if you see in the software in the background here, you see that the controller puts the value to 5 voltage and then put it back to 0 voltage. And then you see how the process reacts on this change. And now it goes back to 5 voltage. So basically this built-in auto-tuning feature changes the manipulated value between 5 voltage and 0 voltage, and then observe the output of the process. And based on that, it calculates a proper set of PID parameters. So typically this auto-tuning takes 1 to 2 minutes based on the process that are used. And when the auto-tuning is finished, as you see now, this blinking here is gone. So now the auto-tuning is finished, and the PID controller are now using the new PID settings. So let's go into this channel where I change the PID parameters. I hold the select button for a few seconds, select channel number 2, hold the select button, and then you see the P now is was 125, now it's set to 15%. The I was 20, now it's set to 17%, and the D settings is now 3.2 seconds, while it was 0 seconds earlier. So this is the new PID settings that the controller now are using based on the built-in auto-tuning functionality. So now you see the process value is 25 and the set value is 25. So let's just change it to 26 or 27 and let's see if the controller is able to reach the new process value or the new set value. So now you see, when I change the set point, the controller starts to react and the process value are reaching the new set value. And as you see here on the controller, I changed the set value from 25 to 27, and you see the new PID parameters was working quite good, so it didn't take long time in order to reach the new set value, which is now 27. So that's how the built-in auto-tuning feature is working. So basically just go click select for a few seconds, go into channel number 1, and then turn on AT, which is auto-tuning, set it to on and select it, and then you see it starts to blinking and the controller are now starting to find new PID parameters based on this auto-tuning feature, which is built into the PID controller.
So that's all. So good luck using your Fuji PX G5 PID controller. Thank you.